Good evening, one and all. Today, I shall be sharing with you a few drops from the ocean of achievements of the illustrious personality we have amongst us, Mr. S.K. Jha. Sir did his master in science in physics and also holds a degree of LLB. Being a consistent topper throughout, sir was awarded with national scholarship. Bright as he was, he aimed for the civil services exam conducted by Union Public Service Commission and bagged a position in Indian Revenue Services. During his tenure of service, sir conducted various appreciable exercises for the benefit of the department and country as a whole. His commitment towards the job could not be left unnoticed for long and was felicitated by the finance minister as the best invigilator in the country. He conducted some significant income tax raids in the country during his reign, thereby unearthing some weighty scams. As a representative of the government, sir has participated in various momentous meetings at the international level. Having a distinguished career in the tax department and serving as a noteworthy officer of tax department, S.K. Jha sir retired as prized Chief Commissioner of Income Tax, Pune. Bounteous experience as he has, sir believes in enlightening and sharing the same with the upcoming managers of our country by giving career guidance to the youngsters. He also cherishes writing. To add to his list of hobbies, palmistry is another forte that sir inhibits. Now, I would call upon Mr. S.K. Jha, retired Chief Commissioner of Income Tax, Pune, to share and enlighten us with his words of wisdom.
Respected Colonel Bala, members of faculty, and my young friends, I was a teacher teaching physics before I come to bureaucracy. So today I have come here just to interact with my young friends. You are the future of the country and future corporate citizens who will bring money, business to the country. The topic given to me is GST. It is evening. You must be getting tired for the whole day lectures. Only thing I'm afraid that after that my talk, GST should not mean good sleep time. Prime Minister Modi said that GST means good simple tax. In WhatsApp I see it these days, lot of messages coming. What is the literal meaning of GST? GST, as you all know, is Goods and Services Tax. This was launched on 30th midnight in the Parliament by the President of India. How important is GST can be gauged by the similarities between 1947 Freedom Night and 30th June Night. The famous speech of then Prime Minister Pandit Nehru, tasked with destiny, was something borrowed or compared when launching the GST. When India became independent, we banished the foreigners, banished the Britishers out of our country. Prime Minister Modi said while delivering lecture that the freedom, many princely states, more than 500 princely states joined together to become one united India. Similarly, he made a comparison that there are many taxes which have come together and joined to become GST. I'll explain to you everything about the GST in a simple fashion, not very technical fashion. Before I come to the GST, Goods and Services Tax, the most important thing is the word tax. Now, tax is very important. One of the real intelligent person who was born on the planet was scientist Einstein. Even Einstein found tax is the most difficult thing to understand. We are all very ordinary people. Even today, I am learning income tax. Even today, I mean, nobody can say that they know everything about the tax. So it's a difficult topic. Now, what is tax? Why we require tax? I mean, if can a country be all right without the tax? Answer is no. The history of taxation in the country, it starts from Arthashastra by Kautilya. He happened in the 3rd century BC. He was the advisor and the finance minister advisor of the Chandragupta Maurya. He has written about the taxation system. And then gradually, every state, every king, every nation requires money, tax. Without tax, the country will have no money. You will understand how the money comes in the country. This year, this year's budget, a total budget size is 21 lakh crore. This year's budget is 21 lakh crore. How important is tax, you will understand. 15 lakh crore comes from tax. Tax from the income tax, corporate tax, indirect tax, all this. 1.5 lakh crores come from miscellaneous income, like dividend from the PSUs and sale of the assets. 5 lakh crore is the deficit. It means we don't have money, we borrow. If you see how important is tax, out of 21 lakh crore budget, our 15 lakh crore is from tax. If the country has to grow, our tax system has to be modernized. Our tax income has to grow. In this context, when India became independent, when Constitution of India was made, the Constitution provided that taxes will be raised both by the center and the state. Center, state, but there was a division. Division given in the Constitution. Three lists were prepared. Union list, state list, and concurrent list. Union list, Government of India will make laws for collection of tax. State list, states will make laws to collect tax. And concurrent list, where both can do that. Now, before coming to GST, this is the background. The tax can be divided in two parts. Direct tax and indirect tax. I mean, broadly. Direct tax is levied only by the Government of India, central government, and under direct tax comes income tax. Corporate tax, that's come in direct tax. Indirect tax of union comes excise duty, customs duty, and there are some other related service tax. And in the state list, the most important is VAT. Or when you go to watch the films, entertainment tax you pay. Municipality also levies tax, octroi. So the difficulty faced, now why this is such an important, there was a reason. It was felt for many years that many states have got different laws. And when a businessman starts doing business, he pays tax to the center, he pays tax to the state, and each state different tax. Now, if you buy petrol in Maharashtra, say in Pune, it is very costly. If you buy in Delhi, it's cheaper. Why? The local taxes. So different state, different taxes. That was creating a lot of problem in doing business. Then If the goods is going from one state to another state, a businessman will not only do business in Maharashtra, he will do business all over the country. Tomorrow you will be managers of the big companies. Your companies will be doing business all over the country, many states. Again, different state, different forms, different returns, very big complication. In that scenario, it was felt from quite some time that, okay, leave income tax, direct tax alone, because the income tax only union government comes, states are not participating. But the taxes where both center and states are participating are indirect tax. So here we should bring all the indirect taxes together and make one tax. One country, one tax. That is the motto of the GST. So there will be no barriers. It is unification of the country. With that mission, GST was visualized. Again, this is very important. Indirect tax is very important. Because just now I was talking to one of our faculty members before this my lecture, that out of 130 crore population, only 3.5 crore is filing income tax return. A very small number. But entire 130 crore population pays indirect tax. When a child is born, he starts paying indirect tax by his birth registration fee. When the person dies, there is his death certificate, that fee at the crematorium ground, that is for the dead soul, packed and forwarding to the heaven, another tax. So the tax, indirect tax is there, which is paid by everybody. A pauper, a beggar on the footpath, and a billionaire in the mansion pay the same amount of tax as far as indirect tax is concerned. Direct tax slabs are different, direct tax is different. But indirect tax, it affects everybody. When you buy a matchbox, a beggar pays the same tax on the matchbox which a big businessman like Ambani pays on the matchbox. So it affects everybody. So there was a need for reforms in indirect tax. And secondly, for doing ease of doing business, this was think that we should merge all the taxes and make one tax. Now, this was not possible. Why not possible? Constitution of India. The Constitution of India says that if the state tax is different, state law is different. So, unless you amend the Constitution of India, it is not possible. And for amending this constitutional amendment, it was not an ordinary amendment. This is a constitutional amendment. For the constitutional amendment, 2/3 of the members present and voting should pass in the parliament. And then 50% of the states have to pass in their assemblies. Then President of India affirms that was a tough job. The process has started. The process started in 2003. As early as in 2003, there's a gentleman in Pune only, Mr. Kelkar. He was finance secretary at the Government of India. It was his team. He had made a study report of the GST. But things didn't happen, went this and that, lot of things happened. I will not go back to what happened. Ultimately, in 2016, September, Parliament passed 122nd Amendment, as per which this position was said that state and centre together will pass law on the common tax, which was called GST, Goods and Services Tax. Now all the states have ratified. So this was the beginning of the GST. Now we are talking too much about the GST. Before I said, I will say, or roughly we can say why this is important. There's a lot of confusion about the GST. There are some economists said that will create problem. Many economists said that's good for the country. To understand, I think all of you are budding economists. You have to decide yourself whether it's good or it is bad. You have to think it over. Generally, it has been thought that it's good. But still, there is opposite voices are also there. Now, before I tell you what is good about the GST, how the GST will be administered, we must know what is the GST. Now, GST name, constitution, everything I told you. Well, what is the theme? What is the spirit? How this works? So, the most important thing about the GST is, compared to the earlier tax, there was an earlier taxation system. There was tax on tax. When a product is manufactured, see, an earlier pre-GST period, a manufacturer will levy excise duty. That duty will be added to the cost. It will go to the wholesaler. He will put his profit margin. Then several state taxes, central sales tax, octroi, state tax, VAT, all together, at every stage there is a tax which goes, which is added in the cost of the product. When it is added to the cost of the product, when ultimately it goes to the consumer, you will be shocked to know there had been a study. The taxes constitute roughly on the average 30% of the cost. It means while a poor man on the footpath is buying a product, he doesn't have thing to eat, but he's paying 30% tax. 30% of the cost is the tax. Only 70% is the actual cost. And this used to happen, or tax on tax. Suppose a good is manufactured, the cost is 100 rupees. Excise duty is added, it becomes 140 rupees, 140 rupees. It goes to the state VAT, tax on the 140 rupees. In a similar chain, ultimately, the price will go on. This is called cascading effect. So, in the earlier system, it is cascading effect. To neutralize this cascading effect, the GST has come, and how this helps. GST has got a system of input tax credit, ITC. It says at every stage, agar aapke paas saman aaya hai inke yahan se, the person, your predecessor, what tax he has paid, that is gone in your hand. See, that input you will get. Similarly, in chain, at every stage, the input tax will get a credit. So ultimately, cost will get reduced. And you will be at every stage, it's only value addition. Cost will be only because of value addition, and that intermediary tax will get credit. So with that thing, that was the important thing in this GST. Now, 17 taxes have been finished, subsumed. In place of GST has come. Few taxes have survived. Custom duty is not there in the GST. Custom duty is a separate tax when the goods come from the foreign country, comes to your things, you custom duty is levied. custom duty is not there. Then there are some items which have not been considered because the states were not agreeing. Why the states were not agreeing? There were a lot of problems in the initial years also. I mean, there was a, people say that when our prime minister was the chief minister of Gujarat, he has got reservation for the GST. Maharashtra government has reservation for the GST. Tamil Nadu government has reservation for the GST. Why? They had a very genuine reason. Because Tamil Nadu, Maharashtra, Gujarat, were the three main states where goods were manufactured. So, in the early system of taxes, when the state which is doing the manufacturing, that state gets the tax of the excise duty and everything. That state gets the tax. And the state sells, even get the VAT. But GST, the difference is, it is a destination-based tax from manufacturer to the consumer. So the states which were earlier rich by manufacturing will have some problem. And that's the reason that Tamil Nadu, even till late Tamil Nadu was not on the board, but ultimately they came on the board. And that was the reason that it was delayed. This bill amendment was passed only when Government of India promised in writing that for 5 years, the states which will have revenue loss, the central government will pay the loss. Without the consent, it was not possible. So this had been, that was the problem, and that is a, even today, the backward states like Bihar, Orissa, I am from Bihar, from backward state. So please don't mind which state I say backward state. The backward states will benefit because they are the consumer states. It's a destination tax. But with the proposal that everybody will be, loss will be repaid by the, so the things will be there. Now, the cascading effect stoppage is the spirit of the GST. Now, one problem, why the many economists are saying this is, GST is good, but not very good as in the present form. The economists are right, but economists are wrong also. Right, because when I say one nation, one tax, unfortunately, this tax rate which we have levied in the GST, which I proposed, is 0%, 5%, 12%, 18%, 28%. Then in the sinful product, excessive cess also is there, like tobacco and cigarettes. Now question is, it's a very debatable issue. You have to apply your mind that one country, one tax, then why so many rates? The Government of India, our Honorable Finance Minister has explained, that is his word, that our country is different from the other countries. Our country, 30% population is below the poverty line. Majority are above the poverty line, they're also poor. His word is, how can you levy the same tax on Hawaii chappal and the motor car? This is Mr. Jaitley's word. Hawaii chappal and the motor car. Hawaii chappal, a person on the footpath buys, and motor car, a rich middle class or higher rich class, they buy. Who they cannot be, there was earlier proposal that we can have one rate, say 16% or 18%. Now if you put 16%, 18% rate for all the, then there will be huge inflation. And This historically correct fact, we have learned from the lesson, historically in each country, wherever GST has been implemented, inflation has gone up at least for 2 years. So considering all those things, that inflation will go up. Different rates have been said. The product which is used by the poor class, no tax. Semi-poor class, 5%, like that. Super rich, 28%, and more than that, 28% plus SS. So that is the reasoning of the government. But still, it's a debatable issue. In the present scheme of the things, all the grains, most of the food items, which are not packaged full items, not non-packaged full items, they have been kept exempt. Export has been kept under zero tax. Supply to SEZ, zero tax. So, majority of the consumable stores which affect poor class is out of the tax net. And that's the reason that there is no inflation going up. In fact, there was a saying, it is an accepted fact in the world, that whichever country has gone for the GST, the next two elections they have lost. Because inflation, because topsy-turvy in the market, Apple card is disturbed, fear of the unknown. I don't think our countrymen will decide in 2019 whether this is good and this or this is bad. Majority of economists say it's good. Some say opposite view also. Now, GST is unique in our country. It's different because you will be reading that last country we had done GST is Malaysia. Total so far, 160 countries have gone for the GST. 160. France was the first country. In 1954, France has gone for the GST. That was the first country. Why GST in India is unique? It's different. No foreign economist can compare. In fact, there was a very bad article against our government in a leading magazine called Economist. Economist is a leading magazine, but they have been very critical of our affairs. The mistake which the foreign economists do, that they cannot visualize, our market is 130 crore. The biggest market before our GST was European Union, EU. The population of European Union, which was the biggest market till we have gone for the GST, was 51 crore. After Britain going for the Brexit, Britain population is 6 crore. If 51 crore after Britain will come out from the EU, it will be 45 crore. You think 45 crore and 130 crore, how can you compare? And in that, so, secondly, it's a very difficult for any economist to compare our thing. Like same happened in demonetization. Many economists say it's very bad for us, bad for the economy. But our countrymen, our poor countrymen, they have appreciated the government's stand. So I don't want to make it political. What will happen in the election, that the citizens of the country will decide. Now, GST, what are the advantages? Why you have gone for main one most important advantage I have told you, removal of the cascading effect. Removal of the cascading effect is the most, that's the spirit of the GST. But in addition to that, we have got several advantages which we have to count. Number one is simplification. Simplification of tax procedures. Now just think, a businessman doing business in all the states and with Indian government, so many returns, so many details, so many laws, so many compliance. In fact, the biggest problem in our country is too many laws. Too many laws and the long-drawn litigation. Too many laws and long-drawn litigation is the biggest problem our country faces. So we have to reduce the number of laws. And most important is the indirect tax, which is affecting everybody. So we have finished indirect tax, made only one indirect tax, because custom duty is separate. Second important aspect, simplification is one. Second is, I am a taxman. The impression about the taxman is not very good. When I was a small kid, when I used to go for the watch films along with my parents, वो हिंदी में एक डायलॉग आता था कि इनकम टैक्स वालों से दोस्ती करना बगल में काली बिल्ली पालना है. आई मीन सच बैड रेपुटेशन आवर टैक्स पीपल हैव, रेपुटेशन दैट दे आर करप्ट, रेपुटेशन दैट दे विल हैरास पीपल ओनली फॉर टेकिंग ब्राइब. दिस इज ट्रू नॉट ओनली फॉर द इनकम टैक्स एक्ट. This is true for all tax laws, whether it is central excise or VAT or octroi. Octroi you must have seen when traveling on the highway. Checkpoint. Trucks are standing in the queue, waiting for the turn to pay the octroi duty. And along with the octroi duty, the officer of municipality sitting there, he also wants bribe. How much time is wasted? So, the corruption in the tax legislation is the worst thing happening for the country. Okay, so this GST at one stroke will remove corruption. How? I'll explain to you. Corruption happens when you come to my office, you have got tax problem, you come to my office, I put fear in your mind. Aapka case is bahut kharab hai. I give all the more fear, and then the taxpayer says, please sir, sort it out, this is my bribe. So the corruption comes because of the physical personal interface between the taxpayer and the tax collector. If the taxpayer and tax collector do not meet, the scope of corruption is not there or is minimized. GST, you don't have to go to any office. You have to just file online. In fact, monthly you have got to file that return, annual return you have to file, and that is end of it. You don't have to go to the offices. If some queries they have to raise, they will give you the email. In the extreme limited case where in-depth scrutiny is called for, or some raid has taken place, then you will have to be called. Otherwise, no, you will not know who is my tax officer. Now, most of the, since I have seen income tax department for 35 years, most of the chartered accountants and advocate, their job is to become a liaison man. They will find who the tax officer of my client. And even if the client is honest, the chartered accountant will create bad name of the tax department and ask for the bribe. I'm saying a big racket is going on. So when physical interface is gone, corruption will go away. 99%. That's one aspect. That's a very important aspect. That is the motto of our Prime Minister. Next point, tax evasion. I think you all are very youngsters. You must have gone to a jewelry shop along with your mother. for buying jewelry of your mother or sister for the marriage and everything. The dukan wala puchta hai, kacha bill chahiye ke pakka bill chahiye? Because pakka bills means proper bill, tax, pay tax. Nobody will like to, no ordinary people will like to pay extra money for that. You say, I am concerned with buying a jewelry, take your cost, I'll take kacha bill. Kacha bill, the consumer is happy, dukandar is also happy, because the entire sale goes in the black money. So tax evasion is there. And biggest tax evasion is there when the excise with the factory. I will just tell you a small story from my side, then you will understand. I was the income tax rate department in charge of income tax rates in Bombay for 8 years. All the big rates in Bombay I have conducted. So once I went to my guru or my mentor and asked him, sir, where should I conduct rate? Please guide me. My mentor said, please find out which commodity attracts maximum excise duty. That commodity which attracts maximum excise duty, the businessman will clear the goods behind the back of the department and it will go in the black market. No excise duty paid. Raat ko 12 baje truck aayega, truck saman le jayega, tax saman nikal jayega. And entire product goes in the black market. The businessman earns a lot of money. He can create problem for his competitors because he can sell the goods at a cheaper price. So the main source of tax evasion is chori of excise duty. Now with this, nobody, entire thing is to be online. If you don't go on the online, your product will not go, product will be in no man's land. There has to be supply chain. You cannot be outside the supply chain of the GST. From the factory to the consumer, the chain is there. Each buyer will ask whether you have paid tax or not. Forget the government department. Now she is buying goods from her neighbor. She will have to find out whether my neighbor has paid tax on that or not. Because then only she can claim input tax credit. If her predecessor has not paid the tax, he cannot claim the income tax. So there is no scope. Excise duty has to be paid. So there is a chain reaction. There is a chain reaction for stopping the excise duty, evasion of excise duty. I was wondering, I'm being a taxman, even I don't understand why. There is some agitation going out in the country, mainly in Gujarat and also in Rajasthan by the textile traders. Now textile, the 5% tax GST rate hadn't applied. If they claim the input tax, income tax on against 5%, it will go down to 2% or 3%. The issue, what I am raising is, tax has to be paid finally by the consumer. The businessman, the trader will collect tax and pay to the government. So collect tax from the consumer and pay tax to the government. What's the difficulty of the traders? Difficulty, yes, you will realize. Their income was earlier chori. Their income was, particularly, I don't want to, but I'll openly say that's the main fact. I have conducted a lot of raids, investigation in Surat. The leading textile mills in Surat, where the maximum agitation is going on. There's a lot of tax evasion cases were there. So the traders will lose the income which they were earning, unaccounted income which they were earning. Before the GST, they are creating agitation. Because ultimately the citizens of the country, they are not doing any agitation. The traders are doing the agitation. This is very, very surprising, even I can't understand. Because right in the beginning I told you that GST is an indirect tax. Indirect tax, you collect from the consumer and pay to the government. The next important advantage of GST is, I told right in the beginning, our biggest problem is our tax base is very narrow. Income tax, I told you 3.5 crore people are filing income tax return. Out of 3.5 crore, more than 1 crore are filing tax return only for getting a refund. Their income is not much. Only 42,000 people are having income more than 10 lakhs. That's very, very sad. Similarly, in the indirect tax, tax base has been very, very narrow. Only 80 lakhs. 80 lakhs tax base. Now, with this online transaction, when everybody has to be a part of the chain, the tax base will increase, both in the income tax and indirect tax also. The widening of tax base, which is the most important thing for our country, we cannot increase our tax unless our tax base increases. It's one aspect. Next important advantage is business ease. Many foreigners, they do not want to come to India to do business. We are well below the list in the ease of doing business. If I remember correctly, we are at 130 serial number out of the list of 185 countries of the listed people. Why they don't want to do business in India? Because of different tax laws in different states. And secondly, too much complication in tax laws. Nobody is clear about the tax laws. So if I am making one tax and simple procedure, no paperwork, it will help our ease of doing business. While doing on the ease of doing business, I'll just give you a small example of the income tax. There was a famous case of Vodafone. Vodafone won the case, Bombay High Court, Vodafone lost. Supreme Court, Vodafone won. There was a case, I don't want to go to the case of the case, because Vodafone acquired the business in India from, and the actual owner of the business was a small cell company in some island tax haven. I don't want to, that is a different lecture altogether when I talk to the finance students. What I'm trying to say, Supreme Court says that Vodafone, no tax we have to pay. So much confusion. Parliament amended the law, changed the law retrospectively, and said, nullifying the Supreme Court decision. That is not very ethically correct. Technically, it's correct. Parliament has got the power. But ethically, not correct. The foreigners say, what is this? What is India when the tax laws are so always in turmoil? How we can do business in India? So, simplification of tax law, procedureless, doing fast, these are very, very important aspects for doing business. GST brings all these aspects in the case. Now, while on the GST, who will have to pay GST? Government of India has taken a precaution that poor traders, small traders, should not suffer. So what is that position? Position is, if your turnover is 20 crore and below, you don't have to pay GST. I think the small traders, Panwala, Biriwala, all those things, 20 crores means almost more than 1.5 lakhs per month. So all will be covered. Again, second slab, if you have got a turnover up to 75 lakhs, again, nominal tax of 1% and 1.2%, that is there. So a provision has been said that these people will not have to pay tax. That advantage is there. Secondly, as I said, that the food grains and all those things will be outside the GST limit. Similarly, there are some exempt services, because our GST is unique, because it's a dual system, both goods and services. It's a dual system. It is second in the world after Canada. Canada is the first having a dual system. We are the second. Now, services. Services like education, health care. If you go to the doctor and doctor says GST, no GST. Education, again, there is a clarification required. A certain aspect will be there, but broadly, special cases, tax GST will be levied. There is still clarification is still in the process of coming. But in a major way, barring some clarification, some areas of doubt are still there. I say every day law clarifications are coming. But services like healthcare and education, GST is not there. There is more benefit given to the school level education than the higher colleges. A school level, a lot of benefit has been given. So who will pay tax? What is the advantage of GST? I have tried to go through. Now what can be disadvantage? So far I have been talking about the advantages. I do not say that a disadvantage, but I differently say there is some big teething problem facing the GST. But the most important thing is many of our traders are not computer savvy. An entire thing has to be done online. So either they have to hire somebody who knows computer, or they have to buy computer, they have to hire somebody computer, or they have to learn computer. This is initial problem, because you cannot be offline, you have to be online. That is one problem. Secondly, at least once in a month, in many parts of the country, the internet facilities are not 2 hours satisfaction. There is no electricity. The government has said at least once in a month you will get that entire thing will be done. So these are the teething problems. One main problem is there. If any of you is from South, you will understand in South, this was happening in excise duty, but things have been removed. In South, people use coconut oil as edible oil. But coconut oil is also used as a hair oil. So there is thinking whether it's edible oil or whether it is a cosmetic product. If it is a hair oil, it is a cosmetic product. If it is a edible oil, so the tax rates are different. This happened in the old central excise regime. Lot of litigations took place whether coconut oil is edible oil or coconut. Similarly, government has in the GST categorization, government had done its best to make a specific mention of this product, but all products cannot be mentioned. So group of products have been classified. Now whether this, since the problem of, of having many tax rates will be, every product will like to fall in the lower tax bracket. Lower tax bracket. Just to give an example, I had a very big case in Pune. I don't want to name that businessman. The gutka. Gutka, very famous gutka manufacturer was there from Pune. There's a lot of litigation. I was there as a judge. There's a lot of litigation. Whether gutka is a tobacco product or gutka is a mouth freshener. If it is a mouth freshener, there is less tax. In excise duty also, and income tax also. If it is a sinful tobacco product, there is no exemption. Because the income tax, there was a provision that if you start a factory, I will not go for the income tax right now. So similarly, such items, there were a lot of item matter went to the High Court and all that, that is a different matter. What I'm trying to say, product fighting for the lower tax rate will create litigation. Product fighting for the lower, because there's, had there been only one tax rate, there was no scope of litigation. Now 28% product will like to fall in the 12% product. So, question up. In fact, to tell very frankly, many advocates and chartered accountants are very happy. They will be many litigation and they will earn more money. So, these are the small things because tax rate are too many. Tax rate are too many. Products will fight for the lower tax bracket. This is another aspect. Thirdly, there is a lot of, the fingers are crossed. Government is not speaking. Some economists say that the tax collection, the budget collection of the government of India and even the state will fall. There are two views are there. I say finger crossed, we pray. We require money. The government faith is praiseworthy. Government faith is on the widening of tax base. If more people join the tax base, even chota chota tax bhi aayega, to tax jyada aa jayega. But the other view also, and there is a feeling that government may lose tax. And then government has to compensate the manufacturing estates for the loss for the 5 years. So things will settle down by coming budget, by the budget of say 2018. Things will settle down and we will know. But my feeling, my personal feeling is that tax collection will go up because tax base will increase, tax will go up. Tax collection has to go up. This is my gut feeling, but I am not an economist. So many economists have said for and against. There is also a feeling, there was earlier when GST was launched, that our growth will increase. Now there is a lot of confusion that whether growth will increase or not. So now we are, after demonetization, we have a little bit fallen in our growth. It is 6% and all those things, 7%. So In this category, there is a lot of confusion whether our growth prospect will go up or go down. So in that context, the confusion is there. But technically, this is a good legislation. Things should improve. Teething problem will remain. Now coming to the next aspect altogether. Administration of GST. Now earlier we used to have service tax officer, central excise officer, VAT officers. Who will administer the GST? Who will be my officer? Even if it is online, there was curiosity that who will be my officer. There was a lot of confusion on that, but it had been sorted out. Before I come to that aspect, what is the amount? In the GST administration, the most important body is GST Council. GST Council, the name has been mentioned in our amendment bill. So the GST Council has got a support from the Constitution of India. Now it is a GST Council who will decide rate change, tax rate, which goods will be exempt, all those things. This is the apex body. Not the state finance minister, not the state chief minister, not the central finance minister. Now, who are the members in the GST Council? GST Council will have members, finance minister of our country, state finance minister of our country, in charge of the revenue, all finance minister of all the states, or any minister selected by the chief minister. And they will be assisted by revenue secretary and other related chairman, CBAC, and other related government officers who will help them. So in the tax administration of the GST, the apex body will be council, GST Council. Between September 2016 and June 2017, this GST Council met 40 times in different parts of the country. And they decided a rate. The rate was decided 5%, 12%, rate was decided by the GST Council, and with God's grace, unanimously. All the state, for political reasons, they may speak something outside. But in the GST Council, everybody, this is a very good thing for the country. Every state unanimously, no voting done, they decided about the GST rate and the administration of the GST. Now I was saying that who will be my officer? Again, there were a lot of confusion. Who will be in the absence of the VAT commissioners and the excise commissioners or service tax commissioner, who will be the commissioner in charge? There, it has been now resolved that all the assesses having turnover up to 1.5 crores, up to 1.5 crore turnover assesses, 90% will fall in the state jurisdiction. 90% of the all the businessmen having turnover of 1.5 crore and below will go to the state, 90%. 10% will go to the center. Now who will decide? There is a software mechanism. Software mechanism will decide 10% with SSE. They will select without any bias. After 1.5 crore turnover, what will happen? So above 1.5 crore turnover, the assesses will be divided into two parts, 50%, 50%. 50% will go to the center and 50% will go to the state. So this is the division of the jurisdiction, and that will be different. Now, one very important aspect which I have not mentioned so far is the segment of GST. GST, one tax, etc. One thing. Segment of GST and procedure to collect the tax. The segment of the GST, you must have read in the newspapers, but probably will not understand, is CGST, SGST, IGST, and UTGST. Now, SGST and CGST. I will come one by one. S, the name suggests, is state GST. C suggests center GST. When a business is within a state, within a state only, if a business is trading is done only in Maharashtra, okay? Not outside Maharashtra, then the two tax will be levied in equal proportion, SGST and CGST. Okay? The businessman will have to, so tax rate will remain same. Suppose 18% is my tax rate of my product. In 18% tax rate of the product, suppose the tax comes 1,000 rupees. Suppose. So the 1,000 rupees tax will be divided in two parts, 500 and 500. The businessman will fill that return, pay 500 to SGST and 500 to the CGST. What is the reason behind that? Reason that no human element coming, money directly going to the kitty of the center, or money going directly to the kitty of the state. Moment you file the return and pay tax, automatically money go to the center. So, amount is same, tax paid is divided. Tax paid is divided into two parts, SGST and CGST. Understand? Now, if a businessman is trading going outside his state, then what will happen? In his state, SGST, CGST will remain. If moment you go outside the border of the state, do you finally sell the product in that state? A concept of IGST comes. IGST, the full form is integrated GST. Integrated GST. There will be collection of tax at the same rate, 18%, again 18%. At the same rate, tax will be collected and put under the banner of IGST. But moment you sell the product in the other state, against your tax liability of SGST and CGST in that state, you can claim back IGST. So IGST, then what is the purpose of complicating this IGST? Why is the IGST required? The purpose of creation of IGST is to have forensic footprint. Once the goods outside goes outside my state, I must locate the footprint where it has gone. So I collect the money from IGST and you claim this money only when you sow the seed in another state. Okay, so ultimately the IGST is under the jurisdiction of the government of India. IGST is not under the jurisdiction of the state, but it is a temporary kitty. Temporary kitty, if money comes and money goes. Temporary kitty. Similarly, IGST is also levied when goods are imported. When goods are imported, IGST is levied. Again, the imported goods will be, once it is sold, IGST set off to begin. Again, why this IGST on imported goods? With a massive scam on bogus import. Goods come from the thing, in fact, I don't want to, but anyway, I will say, I was a person, I detected when the steel king of the country, I found that import is coming in the bogus. He is financing the money from Singapore and Hong Kong. Money come, that goods come in the bogus name. His driver, servant, some poor people, and then goods goes in the black market. What I'm trying to say, the government of India has thought that there had to be again the forensic footprints of the imported goods. Kahan ja raha hai saman? So we can locate. And otherwise we are, the goods come, imported goods are lost. Now there is a racket of the Chinese imports. Goods are come. Now once the importer has to pay IGST, which is a substantial amount of tax, we know where the money, goods are going. Regular importer, bogus importer, we will catch them. So this IGST is also there when the goods are imported. Like SGST is UTGST. There are 7 Union Territories where, just like the states, when the goods are sold in that Union Territory, UTGST will come in the picture. So this is the mechanism of GST, IGST. Now, we have gone through the basics. Basic of the GST, advantages, disadvantage, GST and that. Before I come to your question, I will like that you should ask me. Only thing I will not be able to hear from what you say. But if anybody has got question, I will like to answer that question. Only thing that. GST, there are certain products. I told you that it is not ideal. The ideal GST which was visualized, we have not been able to implement. First, different rates. One more ideal thing which has not been implemented is the most important product is petroleum. Petroleum, maximum indirect tax is levied on petroleum. And then alcohol. The states were, and the major income of the state government is the tax on the alcohol and tax on the petrol. Right in the beginning I told you that petrol is cheaper in Delhi and very costly in Maharashtra. 75 rupees a litre here, 65 rupees a litre there. Why? The Maharashtra tax is very, very high. There was a lot of confusion, but the states didn't agree. So what was decided? Temporarily, if there is a success of the GST, they said that will keep temporarily, it will keep alcohol and petroleum outside the ambit of the GST for the satisfaction of the state. Otherwise, they were not ready to accept. Because from 2003 to 2017, it took 14 years to bring GST to our table. Because states were not angry, not happy. But this is a big lacuna. I admit and say very clearly that the big lacuna in our GST is the most important two items we have kept outside the GST. By keeping these two items outside the GST, you will be shocked to know that roughly 30% of the tax is outside the net of the GST. Because the major is the petroleum and alcohol. So, if these two items come, we hope that in a year or 2 years, when the states come to understand GST, and when they feel that it is not bad, then probably alcohol and petroleum products will also come. The moment these products come, GST will be ideal. Again, there is a view. In fact, I'm referring to the Revenue Secretary, who is the highest government officer for the GST, Revenue Secretary. He is Mr. Adia. He's a gold medalist from IIM Ahmedabad. Then he joined IAS. He has said, okay, we have got too many rates. At least two rates we like to plug in, bring together, 12% and 18%. 12% and 18% rate will be become one rate, sooner or later, maybe in a couple of years' time. So more and more rates are less, there will be less litigation. That's very, very important. Now, the impact of the GST, I don't say that the share market is an ideal platform. Share market is not the ideal platform. Share market moves with sentiments. But some element is also there. GST has been welcomed massively by the share market. The Sensex has gone up to 32,000 point. I mean, a big jump from the earlier Sensex. And they have welcomed, and the companies which are doing very well in the stock exchange are the companies you would like to join. I'll bless all of you to join such companies. So what I'm trying to say, the stock market has welcomed, FMCG companies are doing very well. So I feel that GST has been welcomed by India. There are negative voices, there are teething problems. Teething problems will be there. You have reached here after graduation to a good, very renowned institution, Balaji. But in the process, when you have been a school kid and to reach here, you must have gone sometime difficult process, passing a school examination, going to the college, parents asking for the better marks. So all the problems you have reached here, after 1.5 years, you will leave this campus as a corporate citizen. What I'm trying to say, even GST is having a teething problem. So this will subside in 6 months' time. This is normal vision of the GST. In a small gathering, I will like to discuss by giving the example, because I have vaguely said that how the cascading effect will be stopped. What is the actual benefit? I have generally said, because I have to draw the example, I have to make a chain. In a smaller audience, I will do that. Now, the certain products already rates have gone down. In a lighter vein, the costliest car, Longivinia, whatever, how you pronounce? Yes, you know better about the car than me. The price has gone down by 1 crore. Mercedes-Benz price has gone down by 3 lakhs. Even a small car, what I'm trying to say, prices are going down. The beauty of the GST is that the so far never get 28% tax is very heavy. 28% tax product, the price will go down, because after the tax input credit is given. Okay. Now there is a possibility. There is one more thing. Of course, many businessmen are already reducing tax because of competitive market. There is a provision in the GST which many businessmen don't like and they have criticized, is anti-profiteering clause. Anti-profiteering clause is, suppose because of my input tax credit, my price is coming down. Sir, I talked about Hindustan Lever and all. My price is coming down because of my input tax credit. Then the businessman has to pass on the benefit to the consumer. But there can be a greedy businessman also. He will like to not to pass on to the consumer and benefit his own pocket. In such situation, anti-profiteering laws has come. Government will call such businessmen, levy penalty, even harsh punishment is there. So this is roughly my viewpoint to GST. Now, any of your question, you can ask, I will.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
So first of all, we are honored to have you on our campus. And my question is, sir, for a tax assessee to be eligible for paying GST, he has to have a turnover of 1.5 crore, right? So if he decides to evade the tax by dividing his business into two subsidiaries of lower values, so can he do that?
Very good question. Firstly, I'll correct your question. Threshold limit is only 20 lakhs, not 1.5 crore. Threshold limit for levy of the tax is 20 lakhs only. After 20 lakhs, tax is levyable. Up to 75 lakh, tax rate is less. 1.5 crore, I said, for the distribution of the workload between the state and the center. Now, your question is very right. You say, ki I will reduce my liability. My turnover is, say, 2 crores. I'll open 5-6 cell companies and make every cell company less than that. Already there, it is a part, because my speech was limited to certain issues. It's very clearly they have written in the law that connected companies will be brought to tax net together. Forget the cell companies. Mostly the big companies, they buy sell to sister companies. Now, if you want to sell your product to your sister company at a very low price, again, they will attract price at the highest rate, which is the market price. So this exact word of the section, I don't recollect right now. But like in income tax also, dealing with sister concern, there is a provision in law, similarly in GST. And this is a case of pure tax evasion. This is a case of pure tax evasion. And for that, there is a provision of law, and there is a position of law even clarified by the Supreme Court of India, like lifting of the corporate veil. Lifting the corporate veil and then find out which are your accomplices in the crime. And tax will be levied at the market price of the product.
So is this a loophole in GST?
Loopholes will be there. In fact, only other day, I was reading in the newspaper, 2 days back, there was a news item that some big chartered accountant was saying that many of his clients are planning. Our Indians are genius to find the tax loopholes. They are not working on positively, they are working negatively right now. But they will not succeed. They are working that they will open many cell companies before the government comes to take notice, will close the cell companies. So, but that is not that easy. Already government has taken the notice and it will be difficult. But yes, I'm saying we are very genius. I mean, I'm telling you, I was an income tax raid in charge in AIF for Bombay. I know how genius our people are.
A very good evening, sir. A very good evening to you, sir. Sir, yeah, my question relates to the textile industry, which you said is being protesting in the state of Gujarat and Rajasthan. So I would like to tell you that they are protesting in the state of Punjab too. I have relatives who are having a textile-based business. To be very precise, it's a shawl industry. So we are manufacturers as well as traders. We supply in the northeastern states of India. So I'll tell you the problem that we are facing. To be very honest, we need to buy the cloth making thread. So we buy that thread, We make the yarn, we give it for washing, drying, we give it for kadai work, and then we give the finishing. So at each stage of these steps that I mentioned, we are paying tax. So these steps that are being followed that are not being followed by the organized sector. For a small trader like us, it's not possible for us to get input tax credit for each stage. So ultimately, we have to pay the main tax burden. So how do we deal with it, sir? We cannot compete with the bigger firms. We cannot compete with Chinese products. Our cost goes up. For a shawl that we produce at 150, the same product is being sold, which has been imported from China at 150. So we go out of business, sir.
I appreciate your question. I partly agree with you and partly disagree with you. Now, my answer is in two parts. First part is that it's an indirect tax. So in the chain of system, whatever tax comes, consumer will pay. And what you are losing from your pocket. Now, the other side in your favor is that Government of India is thinking, particularly in the textile industry, many of the things which you buy, yarn or weaving done or processing done of the textile, many goods are being lost or many goods are returned. When the goods are returned and the goods are lost in the processing and weaving, that how to take care of such losses? In that situation, it is a genuine problem because in supply chain, input tax credit is there. But goods which you have purchased and the goods is lost, how will you deal with that? This is only other day, Union Minister of HRD was here in Pune. He was answering this question to the audience in Pune, and he has said that he will raise this issue before the finance minister. As in today, the answer of the government is that what you are losing from your pocket, you collect from the consumer. It's an indirect tax. Income tax you lose from your pocket. But this is indirect tax, you don't lose from your pocket. But as you have said, because I was in Gujarat for some time, I was in charge of textile mills in Surat. And what I told you, it's my feeling how tax evasion was. I don't say that your business was, but normally they are. I told you that income tax department, there is a lot of corruption. It does not mean that income tax department don't have honest people. They have got honest people. And similarly, you may be facing a problem. What I will suggest, that SGT Subdha Kendra is there in SGT, in the GST office, in the GST office, you raise the issue in the Subdha Kendra, they will advise you. And you can make even online, agitations are going there, but agitation Government of India has not appreciated. I'm telling you, what the Government of India is saying, that 5% tax is there. Your input tax, if you claim the input tax, tax liability will go down to 2% or 3% or 1%. In fact, the problem is, now, I'm just giving an example. Why 5% has been kept? Now, suppose an educational institution, they have got input tax. They cannot claim input tax because their income is exempt. By keeping 5%, you can claim the input tax credit. It will go down to 1%. But if it is 0%, there is no input tax credit can be claimed. Anyway, you have got so far I have answered, because this tax is not fully complete as in today. It is the process of making.
Good evening, sir.
Bully.
So my question is, you stated that the advantages of GST, one was cascading effect and other was ITC, input tax credit. But this already exists, like the cascading effect was taken care by VAT and CST to put together. and the ITC was also available beforehand. So what is new to them that has been added to GST?
Good question. GST is an advanced form, but sit down. GST is an advanced form of the VAT. VAT is limited to the state, one state. Each state has different VAT. Now in the GST, in addition to the VAT, the major taxes is central excise, service tax of Government of India. 17 taxes have come together. So VAT is a concept. VAT is a predecessor of the GST. Definitely, yes. VAT is a predecessor in the GST. And in the similar fashion, now the central taxes are on the same table. And since it's the one country, one tax, so this VAT, this effect, the input ITC, what you say, input tax credit will be for all the goods all over the country on a single basis. That is the importance of that. Otherwise, 29 states we have got, 7 union territories we have got, 36. 36 different VATs were there. And goods going from one state to another state, fee another VAT. And the major central, because till recently, as in today, the highest tax comes from the income tax and corporate tax. But till very, very recently, the highest tax used to come from central excise. Because central excise, everybody pays. So now, all have come together, all on the board. That was an improvement. Now this is super improvement.
A very good evening, everyone. Thank you, sir. On behalf of Sri Balaji Society, I, Juhi Chandra, express my profound gratitude to our guest, Mr. S.K. Jha, retired Chief Commissioner of Income Tax Department, Pune, for sparing his valuable time and to guide us for a successful career. Sir, we are enlightened with your words of wisdom. We are thankful to you for making us understand what GST is and also giving us clarity about taxes. We have gained a lot from you, sir, and we look forward to many more interactions with you on and off the campus. Thank you.